Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Physics Tricks. So in this video I will be giving solutions to the practice problem which I gave in the last video, right? So see here, this is the first question we have. Calculate the area of triangle determined by two vectors A bar and B bar given. So we want what is called as the area of triangle. So over here, area of triangle, we know that is equal to 1 by 2 the magnitude of A bar cross with B bar, okay. So which is equal to, firstly we'll calculate A bar cross B bar and then we'll take the magnitude and divide it by 2, okay. Now, so over here, this A bar cross B bar, firstly we have to write I hat, J hat, K hat, determinant method. So it will be 3, 4, 0, then minus 3, 7, 0. So what is A bar cross B bar then? Firstly I hat you have to take, then 0 minus 0, then minus j hat you have to take, 21 plus 12, then plus k hat you have to take, and we have what is called as okay, so this one I hat we have 0 0, j hat we have 0 0, sorry, over here it is 0, and k hat we have, and this is 21 plus 12, isn't it? So we'll have, which is equal to, this is 33 k hat. This is A bar cross B bar. Now we want area of triangle. So area of triangle we have is 1 by 2 magnitude of A bar cross B bar. What is the magnitude of it? It is root of 33 squared, is nothing but 33 only, that is divided by 2. So we'll write this as 16.5 meter squared right now. So 16.5 meter squared is the answer for the first क्वेश्चन, ठीक है. सो अगर आपका ये आंसर सही हुआ होगा तो गिव वन मार्क टू दिस क्वेश्चन, ठीक है. नेक्स्ट, वी हैव कैलकुलेट द एरिया ऑफ पैरेललोग्राम व्हेन द एडजेसेंट साइड्स आर गिवन बाय दिस इज ए बार एंड दिस इज बी बार. सो एरिया ऑफ पैरेललोग्राम इज इक्वल टू द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ ए बार क्रॉस बी बार, दैट्स इट. सो व्हाट यू हैव टू फाइंड इज ए बार क्रॉस बी बार बाय यूजिंग द determinant method. This is the determinant. We have firstly I hat, then J hat, and this is K hat. 1, 2, 3, that is the A bar's coefficient, then 2 minus 3, 1, B bar's coefficient. So firstly I hat take, then it will be 2 plus 9, then minus J hat, then we have 1 minus 6, then minus plus K hat, then we have minus 3 and minus 4. So if you just solve this, you will get 11 I hat plus 5 J hat and minus 7 K hat. This is A bar cross B bar. We want its magnitude. That is nothing but what? That is nothing but the area of parallelogram. So which is equal to root of 11 squared, that is x component squared, plus 5 squared plus 7 squared. So which is root of 121 plus 25 plus 49. So if you just solve this, you will get root of this is 146 plus 49, and that is root of 195 meter squared is the answer. So I hope this is clear. Likewise, you can solve for parallelogram or triangle, right? So next we have, determine the unit vector parallel to the cross product of the vector, this is given, right? Parallel to the cross product of the vectors, right? So n hat we have to find, and that is equal to A bar cross B bar you have to find firstly, divided by the A bar's magnitude, B bar's magnitude into sine of angle between them. Now how to find sine of angle? Firstly find out the dot product, right? So A bar dot with B bar, I'm writing directly I with I, it is 18, then J with J minus 25, then K with K 20. So it will become this is this is minus 5, so it will become 13. So A bar dot B bar is 13, which is equal to magnitude of A bar root of 9 plus 25 plus 100, magnitude of B bar 36 plus 25 plus 4 into cosine of angle, and that cos theta we have is 13 divided by root of this is 34, so 134, and this is 40, 65, enough. 65 we have into, okay, so this one done. We have cos theta now. We can calculate sin theta. So this is sin square theta. 1 minus sin square theta is equal to cos square theta. We have this is 169, or else we can write 13 into 30 because we are doing the square, divided by 134 into 65. 13 fives are we have, right? Now 13 fives are okay, so it will become sin square theta is equal to 1 minus this is 13 divided by 5 into 134. So if you just solve this, you will get just a minute. Yeah, so we have this is 134 into 5, 670. So sin square theta is equal to 670 minus 13 divided by 670. So if you just solve this, you will get this is 670 minus 13. So you will get 657 divided by 670. So sin theta we have, and that is equal to root of 657 by 670. Okay, so this is sin theta. Put it over here. Firstly, find out now A bar cross B bar. So A bar cross B bar we have is equal to I hat, J hat and K hat. It will be 3 minus 5, 10, and this will be 6, 5, 2. So if you just solve this, you will get I hat in bracket minus 10, minus 50, minus J hat in bracket 6, minus 60, then K hat in bracket 15 plus 30. 15 plus 30. So you will get minus 60 I hat, then plus 56 J hat, and plus 45 K hat. So this is A bar cross B bar we have. So N hat we have is this one, minus 60 I hat, plus 56 J hat, plus 45 K hat. Magnitude of A bar you have to write, that is root of 134. Magnitude of B bar you have to write, that is root of 65 into sine theta you have to write, that is root of we have 657 divided by 670. 657 divided by 670. Now just solve this, you will get this is 60 I hat plus 56 J hat plus 45 K hat divided by root of this is 134 into 65. 134 into 65, it is 8710 into 657 by 670. So this zero get cancelled, then we have this is equal to 60 I hat plus 56 J hat plus 45 K hat divided by root of 871 into 657 by 67. Now just a minute, I'll divide this. 871 divided by 67, it is 13. As you can see, this is 13 into 657 into 657. It is 8541. So 60 I hat plus 50 J hat plus 45 K hat divided by root of 8541, right? So root of 8541. Now I'll just solve this. Okay, so root of 8541, it is 92.41, or else this is the answer we can write. Okay, so this is the N hat we have, which is parallel to A bar cross B bar. So what you have to do is firstly calculate the dot product. By using that, find out the cos theta, right? Sin theta, then firstly cos theta, then by using cos theta you can find sin theta. That sin theta you can put in the formula. Once you got sin theta, you can calculate magnitude of B bar and A bar cross B bar. Put all the values, you will get N hat. Okay, next, a vector perpendicular to I hat plus J hat plus K hat is Okay, so a vector perpendicular to this is what? So we have, firstly we have to take this A bar, dot product with the first one, A bar, dot product with the second one, A bar, dot product with the third one, and A bar, dot product with the fourth one. And the one which you will get as zero, that is the answer then. First one, it will be 1 minus 1 plus 1, which is 1. Second one, 1 minus 1 minus 1, which is equal to 1. Then third one, 1 minus 1 minus 1 minus 1, it will become minus 3. So fourth one, 3 plus 2 minus 5 is equal to 0. So what is the answer? Fourth one is the answer right now. So vector perpendicular to I hat plus j hat plus k hat. Now why I consider this? Because dot product of two perpendicular vector must be 0, and that is the reason fourth one is the correct option. Fifth one now. What is the angle between two vector forces of equal magnitude such that their resultant is one third of either of the original force? So we have F1 is equal to F2 is equal to F, and the resultant is given one third of the original force. So just use the formula. It is F squared divided by 9, that is R squared, is equal to A squared, so F squared, B squared, that is F squared, plus 2AB, that is 2F squared cos theta. So you will get F squared by 9 minus 2F squared is equal to 2F squared cos theta. You can take F squared common and cancel it out. You will get then it will be 1 by 9 minus 2, which is equal to 2 cos theta. So what is the answer then? It is 18. 1 minus 18 is minus 17, divided by 18 is equal to cos theta. So what is theta? Cos inverse minus 17 by 18. So what is the answer? Option A. Chalo. So the angle between A bar plus B bar and A bar cross B bar is okay. See, A bar plus B bar, this is A bar, this is B bar, and A bar plus B bar we have is in this manner, right? This is A bar plus B bar, but A bar cross B bar is always perpendicular to A bar and B bar, so that indicates in this manner. So what is the angle between this vertical vector? Vertical means towards you, right? And this horizontal in a plane, right? Horizontal vector, we can say it is 90 degree. 90 degree. So what is the answer? 90 degree is equivalent to pi by 2 radian. So third is the correct answer. Then after this we have, out of the following set of forces, the resultant of which cannot be zero. I have explained this in the previous question, then do I'll explain over here. So 10 comma 10 comma 10, you have to consider these two forces, right? Consider these two forces. The minimum possible is 0, maximum possible is 20. This third vector, that is 10, right? That is 10, is lies in between 20 and 0. So yes, its resultant is 0 possible. Second one, 10 comma 10 comma 20. So see, the minimum one 0, maximum one 20. Yes, this 20 lies over here, so resultant 0 possible. Third one, 10 comma 20 comma 20. So over here, the minimum possible is 10 and the maximum possible is 30, and this 20 lies in between 10 and 30, so resultant 0 possible. Fourth one, 10 comma 20 comma 40. So over here, as you can see, the minimum is 10, maximum is 30, and this 40 is out of the boundary of this 10 and 30, so we can say resultant 0 cannot be possible by using these three forces. Okay, so I hope this is clear, right? So whenever third vector does not lie in between the maximum and the minimum value of the two vectors, then by using that three vectors, resultant cannot be zero possible. Okay. Okay, eighth question. If A bar plus B bar is equal to A bar, which is equal to B bar, then angle between A bar and B bar is, over here that indicates resultant is equal to the magnitude of A bar, which is equal to the magnitude of B bar, and this is the property. It is possible only when the angle between two vectors must be 120 degree, yeah. So this is the answer, 120 degree, that is option A. The projection of vector this on xy plane has magnitude. Xy plane means what? X and y. So magnitude we want is root of 9 plus 1, which is root of 10. That is the fourth answer. And the last one, the resultant of two vectors A bar and B bar is perpendicular to the vector A bar, and its magnitude is equal to half of the magnitude of vector B bar. So this R bar is given, half of the magnitude of B bar, so B by 2, the angle between A bar and B bar is. So firstly find out this beta. So we have cos beta is equal to the adjacent, that is B by 2, divided by the hypotenuse, that is B. BB get cancelled, it is 1 by 2. So and this beta is equal to 60 degree. This beta 60 degree indicates the angle between A bar and B bar is 150 degree. So why 150 degree? With this 90 plus this 150, this 90 plus this 60 is 150 right now. So answer is 150 degree. Okay, so all these questions are very simple if you know the basic concepts.